Hi and welcome to Watch and Work. Watch and Work is ContiTech's series of service videos for automotive mechanics. My name is Stefan Meyer and I'll show you a different vehicle engine in each video. Follow me. This video is aimed at trained professionals, not DIYers, okay? Let's go. Today I have a 2003 Fiat Doblo for you. This is a 1.9-liter 77-kilowatt engine with engine code 223A7.000. For this engine you need our CT968WP2 timing belt kit plus water pump. Please have the following OE tools to hand. Once you've removed the timing belt guard and crankshaft belt pulley, you have to set the engine to top dead center at cylinder 1. There are three marks to help with this. You lock the crankshaft using this tool. To do so, you have to remove this screw at the bottom, screw in this pin, and then fit the tool. You lock the fuel pump with the two screws, which you fit in these locking bores. On the camshaft sprocket, we have a recess here and a small triangle in the cladding at the back. The two marks have to align. Loosen the nut on the tensioning pulley to slacken the timing belt. Remove the belt and fit the new components from our kit. To change the water pump, you have to remove the camshaft sprocket. Use the counter hole to do so. When fitting the tensioning pulley, note the special fitting position. The recess here must be positioned over this pin on the engine. When you change the water pump, take care to thoroughly clean and flush the coolant circuit first. Then fill the cooling system with coolant and distilled water. When fitting the pump, do not apply any additional sealing compound paste to the seal that is already there. When fitting the belt, start at the crankshaft sprocket, then continue round the idler to the camshaft sprocket and then across to the fuel pump, then the tensioning pulley and, finally, the water pump. Please note the sequence. To tension the timing belt, you now have to press the lower lever of the tensioning pulley back until the setting mark is positioned at about 2 o'clock. Turn the engine over twice in the direction of engine rotation and reset the timing belt tension. The pointer now has to be aligned with this bore here. Then remove the locking tools and turn the engine over twice in the direction of engine rotation. Once that is done, reset the engine to top dead center. Okay, almost done. You now just have to complete the engine. Follow the manufacturer's specification, particularly when it comes to the torques. Remember, gently does it. Don't forget our quality mark, SR change sticker in a clearly visible location in the engine compartment, so the customer sees that you've installed quality.